Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Alex Brooks, who is an independent non-executive director at Graft Polymer. Alex, it's great to have you on the line, and we're very pleased to be getting an update from you. There was an IPO last year with a view to expanding the production capability, and it's nearly complete, isn't it?
Yes, thank you for having me on the show. And yeah, it's been a fairly long road. We raised money at the IPO specifically to expand the capabilities of the production at Borovnica. And we are getting towards the end of that process, and we're pretty excited about what we're able to offer our customers.
I can quite imagine. So what is it that is about to be installed that is going to represent the culmination of this long process?
Well, I think there's been a whole load of equipment that has gone in. It's all around how we produce polymers, how we connect different polymers together that allows customers to do what they need to do. And that is both for industrial purposes. So we have a number of customers who need products which combine the sort of core properties of different polymers for their industrial processes, whether that's, you know, making exciting equipment for automotive, whether that is for decorative purposes. Some of our customers are using it for sort of marine applications. And then we have this growing business in biomaterials, which is really around how you can do smart things with polymers to deliver materials into people's bodies.
It's quite extraordinary the range of different things that you can offer from this facility, isn't it? There must be something that sets the business apart.
Look, we've got a great team there. We've got a couple of really good chemists who, with a really strong heritage. We've got a good team working for them, and we've got a sales force that has been successful in getting really strong customer engagement in this period ahead of being able to go ahead with the sort of really volume production that we're heading for.
So there's been an announcement very recently that you've signed your first cosmetic deal, I believe, with a firm in Ireland. But what else can we expect once that new capacity is online?
I think the cosmetics is a really good example of what this kind of product can do for you. Because, you know, why are the cosmetics guys interested in it? It's because we're in a position to allow them to get the properties for their material in a very, sort of proven, safe fashion to allow them to deliver the product to the skin or whatever they need. And that, what are we doing? Why is that so interesting? It's because what our expertise is in playing with the way the surface area, the way the volume, right down to a sort of nano scale of these materials that actually delivers whatever the customer wants. And look, if there are plenty more things in the works, there's a number of things which are around cosmetics, there's a number of things which are around active ingredients that are doing something that the seller wants. And we've got a number of opportunities in manufacturing where similarly you're adding in capabilities to a manufacturing process that would be very difficult without our product.
Understood. And just one final question from me, Alex, and it's one that I like to ask people. Is there something that you think investors don't quite tend to understand about the business that you'd like them to?
I think, it's always a challenge with these relatively early stage companies to really get a gauge of the credibility and the depth of the market engagement that you're getting access to and the willingness of customers to really take up the product. And I think, we are very confident that that engagement that we've been in since long before the IPO and over the course of the last 12 months is really going to start to bear fruit through this year.
Alex Brooks from Graft Polymer, thank you very much for coming to talk to us at Proactive today.
Thanks for your time. We'll be right back.